Oh, it's about that time, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, that's not the right screen. There's my face. That's not the right screen either. There we go. We're here. So we're going to be reviewing this Lulu game today. It was a really close game. It's a good example of how even if you're really behind in kills, you can still win because we were ahead in kills and we lost. So never give up, never surrender. It's a good example, I think, of how my item builds could have been a little bit more efficient. When the game happened live, I hung out in the chat afterwards and just really thought about this because we were playing really tough, and we had an AP Malph who was able to one-shot a lot of their squishies. Like, Ahri just died repeatedly. Rengar, when he would try and go in, would get crushed. And it was just a couple of positioning engagements where We went in, some of us were dived, so some of us would dive in, and then we would suddenly be separated. We might get a, you know, picture perfect highlight reel engagement, but if there's no team to follow it up, it just wasn't working out. And I was a little concerned about my positioning in that. Maybe I should have whimsied myself to get there a little bit quicker. Maybe I should have itemized a redemption instead of a locket, because since we're so split up, being able to cast a zone for the redemption further ahead where the engagement was happening could have been better. And so I wanted to pay attention to how many times I used the locket effectively in this game. I want to pay attention to my itemization path because I'm also not sure exactly what route I went through these items in. I think the Mobis are probably correct in this situation for that exact reason. I need to get myself to the action. The Mobis passive wouldn't be disabled because I wouldn't be in combat yet because I'm still trying to get towards the engagement. It wasn't long protracted engagements. It was short starts where we weren't properly all together. So that's what we're going to be on the lookout for. As you may or may not know, YouTube audience, we're going to be just sort of paying attention, seeing what comes of, what lessons sort of present themselves. Oh, the client's being bugged. We're going to see what lessons are presenting themselves. Let me test to make sure this draw on the screen tool is working. Nope, hold on. Do-do-do, re-enable that. You'll see the little squares, and there we go. Perfect. All right, clear that out. So, basic summary so far. We started out with the Windspeaker's Blessing, I think it's called. Tidecaller's Blessing? No, that's Nami. Whatever the passive, or the keystone is where when you give the shield, they get an additional damage on hit. And I took the item Spell Thief's Edge for this exact reason. Try and proc it. They don't have that much damage because Ahri's not going to start charm. If she levels charm first, then our lane wins. So I was able to get all my procs off before Blitz showed up, which is a free health pot for me, and it disrupts their initial invade with Blitz because Blitz wasn't properly grouped with them at the very start. So that was an okay start for us. Blitz does continue to invade here to drop down some deeper vision. We end up answering that. Nothing much else comes of this. So far, so good. Speed up a little bit, get to the action. I head up top just to throw down my control ward. I'm not as punished this game as I usually am because, like I said, I was able to get all the procs off. So instead of just having the one Diskit in lane, I actually get to have two. And right as I'm coming down here to leash, Blitz tries to go back in. He does solo, so even though he gets this hook here, he's just taking a lot of free damage. So luckily, I was able to path through the river, which is a bit more of aggressive of a path because I'm not, one, I'm going into the darkness, and two, I mean, quasi-darkness, right? But near the fog of war. And two, I keep this camera focused on me. I wasn't sure if they were going to do a delayed invade with Rengar and the Mordekaiser. So it was a little dangerous, and upon seeing Blitz reveal himself, sticking with it was also a little bit risky, but since I had that extra gap in time, I was able to realize, okay, it's just Blitzcrank. We can punish this. So he starts in lane, already chunked a little bit. That's good. That's some free damage. Nice. So since I'm Lulu, I'm going to want to be abusing Blitzcrank whenever he tries to go for that Relic Shield stack. Same with Mordekaiser, and especially if he hooks like that and his hook's on cooldown. There's no way they can punch me. I can do shit like this, and like there's no real damage coming my way. I'm eating through the shields that Mordekaiser gets through his passive. I'm getting some good harass. I'm trying to find opportunities to position Lulu away from the minions so we don't shove as hard. So we can keep this up. Luckily, he just misses a point-blank hook there. But also, because Lulu's real damage from her autos comes from the picks. Like, her abilities are some of her harassment, but I would say probably the lion's share is just from the autos and picks is follow-up from that. It stacks up really quickly over time, and it's super easy to just keep getting that off again and again and again. And we do so here. This is another good example. They're going forward, looking for anything, trying to get the Relic Shield stack off. We can't. They just can't do it. So they level a little bit before us here. It's a good time to ward. A little bit delayed, actually, but since now the lane is pushing up, we have a little bit of control and we're going to be going a little bit forward. That was the optimal time to ward, I think. Sooner would have been maybe a waste of a little bit of the time on the ward. And early game, when you're relying on these trinket wards, you don't want to waste any of the cooldown time if you can optimize it. So not too much going on in slinging phase. No, I'm notorious for pausing like 8 times already during the laning phase. And analyzing the hell out of stuff, but I mean, I think this is pretty straightforward and self-explanatory. We're just looking to constantly harass, use our ranged versus melee advantage, and try and chunk them out. Try and make it so if Blitz does get a pull, it's suboptimal. And, you know, again, just lucky for us, Blitz is missing those pulls. Sometimes he hits them, sometimes he misses them, and this game there were a lot of misses, so that helped us out. He was going in at really opportune times when he leveled. So if he did land those pulls, he was going to get an advantage on us, just from, by virtue of them having a higher level. Now, right now, our ward expired, right? So right as this wave was pushing in, if I had that additional trinket ward, I would have been able to come out here and ward this, and I would have been the one face tanking this rather than Ezreal. And Ezreal wants to hang here and get this CS, but there could be a jungler here, right? He could have just taken a path like this. He could have blast coned over into the brush. We don't know. This is a little bit offensive. And even though we need to play offensively to make sure and, again, punish them, once the minion line is about here, it's risky with Blitz's pull to play around here. Because we're going to be pulled into turret aggro range, which is something like that, right? So why take that risk for the minimal? I mean, we see how much the damage has added up, right, onto Mordekaiser, but he's playing way far back. So the only one realistically we're going to be able to harass is Blitzcrank. And with his passive shield that can come out, he's basically at full HP if you want to count that passive shield towards what his effective health pool would be if we were actually going for a kill. So every little chunk would help, but he's not the ideal target. He's a lot tankier than Mordekaiser is when, assuming all things equal, if Mordekaiser throws his little shield on him, that's different. But the real problem from playing forward like this isn't just the risk and the low reward. It's the risk caused by this huge fog of war line we have right here. If I was instead positioning here, or let's say even, because I want to be in experience range to get some passive gold, if I was positioning here, right, we still wouldn't see inside this brush, and assuming the jungler came hugging the wall, I still wouldn't have vision of this jungler, but I would have vision of probably, my sight line would wrap slightly around, so all of this area right around here, roughly, would be our vision. We would have complete vision of that. So when the jungler comes out of the brush, I was here, it would be outside of Rengar's jump range too, because I think his range is something like this. So he would have had to step out of brush. So, one, that's good, because I would immediately know. Two, it's better, because it's Rengar, and instead, I'm walking closely to this wall, and it's within his jump range right here. Seeing Blitz walk forward from his position here means he's looking for an engagement. Seeing Mordekaiser walk forward when we're coming back, a little suspicious because he's so low, and it's possible that he's just following up Blitzcrank, but this is a definite tell. They're low, they've been losing these trades, and let's actually jump back momentarily, because if Blitz had just hooked, we should already know that this gank is happening. Ooh, my glove, there you go. So it looks like his hook is still on cooldown from a previous. Now these are bugged for anybody who doesn't already know that. But I'm gonna work under the assumption that his hook's already on cooldown. So it would be coming off cooldown by the time he's going here. It could be interpreted as he's doing the aggressive kind of thresh thing. You wanna set up with your E first and he would get that knock up and then walk back a little bit and then hook just to chain some CC. But again, it seems a little suspicious, right? Mordekaiser's not going to have much damage to follow up on, and we could just turn and focus Mordekaiser. So this should be a telltale sign that there's a Rengar in this bush, which means I shouldn't be walking this close to the bush, right? This is how the engagement goes against us, right here. Nothing to do with Ezreal, nothing to do with Mordekaiser and Blitz. It's because I bring Rengar into the fight. If I had just walked, I keep losing my little draw tool. If I had walked instead here, Rengar would have had to walk. And he never gets his jump. He never gets his jump unless we hug these brushes down here. And he starts jumping around there. But we wouldn't have to worry about that till we're already so safe we'd be fine. So this is just really poor pathing on my fault. On my side, I'm just not aware of like where the jungler could be. Something I need to start doing is... judging where they started their camps, because he's level 4 right now, right? Here, let me go back to my selected game. So, he's got his items. He's coming off of a back. This is a time, if he's going to gank pre-6, this is a good time for him to gank. He comes in, he gets a camp, he comes to gank. Especially since I had the trinket that had just expired, I need to treat this brush as a danger zone. I need to not walk anywhere near this brush. Instead I do, I bring Rengar into the fight. I throw the shield down on Ezreal because Rengar is very cooldown dependent. Now even though he's going to get his stacks up so he can get another one off, he might be able to burst me out there. I want to make sure that Ezreal survives this damage from the actual bot lane proper. Because maybe he'll be able to trade back a kill onto Mordekaiser here, right? So he's in aggressively thinking the same thing. I flash away. I throw my exhaust onto Rengar. That's good. Once I've made that mistake, that's good. All right. So we're just going to keep focusing on me because I can't control Ezreal at this point, right? So I throw out my Q to try and slow him with the Glitter Lance. I get away. At least I got away there. Again, I don't think I would have had to burn flash and... exhaust so outside of the context of the fight here, and with how low Mordekaiser got, I mean, check that out. That's 180 HP, right? If I had been able to throw down exhaust on Mordekaiser, and I would probably say Rengar would have been as much delayed from entering the fight as he was in this scenario because he was dealing with me the whole time. If he instead had to deal with walking that distance, that would be a significant amount of time. And I could have actually put, you know, my whimsy onto either of these two. I could have put any amount of damage onto either of these two to start off the fight. I think we could have had a kill there. Maybe one of us still would have died. Maybe we would have still had to blow summoners. But I think we could have got a kill on Mordekaiser there if I hadn't brought Rengar into the fight. So that's a single mistake. I think that best way to think about that could be like map awareness. Because even though it's not after a first clear, so I should know just from my own tracking where the jungler is at this point in the game. Knowing that we have a fog of war there, I need to play around that, you know? Can't always mitigate that because I don't always have Sightstone, right? And I actually went upgrade on Frostfang because even though we now are in a 1-0 lane, the kill's on Blitz, who's going Dark Seal, which is funny. And it's not so bad that I don't let me reward this, because this is where action's happening. I'm sure you already heard how this next chunk of action's about to go down. Sorry, just reading Twitch chat there. I've got my Twitch chat off to the left here. I go away there to throw down the ward. It's fine. Nothing else happens. I don't think we're at that bad of a lane disadvantage just with that one kill on their support to where we desperately need to just make our health stronger, expand our vision. That was an unfortunate gank, well played on Rengar's part. But we just got to be aware of that. I'll throw down a deep ward as I just did as soon as I get back to lane. We'll have a little bit more awareness of our vision, through vision of where Rengar is. And we can go back to bullying this lane, because we were chunking them out significantly. The reason Mordekaiser almost died during that gank, and could have died if we played that a little bit better, was because of our harassment. So we need to enable that again, so I get Frostfang, so I can do that kind of damage. I get some extra sustain, so I can last myself a little bit longer. And instead of going the traditional tier, Ezreal has a Vamp Scepter, so he can sustain and lane a little bit better. So we should have more damage output than this lane typically would because we've gone more aggressive items. So maybe we can maintain an advantage, maybe we can bully out. We'll see how that goes. Fortunately, I get Fold to start this off. Throw the shield on myself just to prevent follow-up damage. I get the Whimsy off on the Mordekaiser, take some damage on the way out. Reviewing that, I think I probably could have just run straight out a little bit more effectively. I mean, obviously that can be dodged, right? The shield on myself is right because Blitz is going to stick on me. Even though Ezreal could be making use out of the passive picks, he doesn't have like a whole bunch of attack speed yet, so it's not nearly as relevant. Protecting myself so I can fight a little bit longer is better. Seeing that they're still fighting, I turn to Whimsy and become a bunny for Mordekaiser. I think hanging around in the thick of it for that Q, even though I do proc the Q on both of them, that's some nice gold. You know I love me the gold, I greed for that gold. It keeps me positioned all the way up here. If I had instead run, instead of pausing, channel, then run again, I could have probably been around here at this point. Maybe here, depending on how I pathed, right? So would any of follow-up damage of Mordekaiser had hit me if I had pathed that way? Oops, let's click here. Yeah. I'm so barely on the edge of this. I mean, you can see from the particles, right? This is the line. Even if I had... Some of this was Mordekaiser being slowed from the Whimsy, right? So he might have been positioned a little bit forward. But he was pathing this way to try and maximize the damage to the minions and to prevent some Ezreal harass for free, right? So he was going to path in kind of this bowed out direction regardless. So if I had gone, I don't know, if I hadn't Whimsied or had wait to, or Glitter Lance rather, or waited to throw out my Glitter Lance just a little bit longer, I could easily be here right now, could easily be here right now. And this doesn't hit me, I don't take this damage, so this next chunk of damage could have been avoided. Not the biggest thing, but that does add up. Again, this is a lane where we should be throwing out the poke. We should be throwing out the grass. So if we're falling behind in that, that's pretty bad. Because now we just have to answer. Blitz gets a really good hook there. I'm not respecting that hook potential. I think at this point, because this was pinged out, I'm not sure if it shows on the minimap. Yeah, it does show even now. So at this point, Gragas pings that he's coming. So I'm thinking, all right, let's try and figure out a way to get them in. So I actually do think I was playing a little bit forward to bait this. Nonetheless, I was not expecting a fucking flash pull. That was a surprise to me. So it's certainly good that we got Gragas here to follow up on this, and it mitigates how bad this could have been. But it still was a little bit aggressive of me to play as. Since I don't have either summoner spell available, you know, it would be different if Ezreal's flash was down and mine was still up, right? But because I'm so low, I'm putting myself at really high vulnerability to being dead before this gank comes off. So I have to then immediately burn the shield on myself. I have to then try and whimsy whoever's nearest to me, not whoever's optimal, just to get away and run. So, not the best. I think I do live here. I actually was able to position myself far enough to feel comfortable getting the whimsy off on Mordekaiser, so it mitigates the damage onto these two. And then Blitz has been isolated because of the ganks here. So this ends up working out, but I think this was a little bit greedy positioning. I probably could have been a bit farther back here and baited just as effectively. He ends up getting smoked. I get the shield onto Ezreal so he can try and get some of that pix damage. Fortunately, that means I won't have it available here to block any of that damage. It's only the last turret shot onto Gragas I'm able to block. But that little bit of extra damage did come in handy because both of them were tanking the turret. That if we had to wait for one more auto on Mordekaiser, it might have meant one of them went down. So, you know, going for a guaranteed whimsy there. Or help picks there. Probably the right thing to do. I mean, this... I hope you guys don't judge me too harshly for not being able to make this play better. Like, this is just... I think Ezreal was typing or watching elsewhere on the map. So, seeing that engage happen, like, maybe there was something I could have done, right, to make this better. You're not going to be surprised to find out that he goes down here. But seeing Ahri come in like this, it's right... Let me... I'll go back to our vision only, right? Here she is. I already have vision that she's here. So at this point, we need to run. So I should immediately give Ezreal the speed boost. Even if he turns to go back in to greed for that last cannon, right? You know, who doesn't want that 46 gold? Come on, you know you want that. You know you want that 46 gold. So right here, I should throw the whimsy down on him to make him run really quickly. And get out of here for sure. He does have flash available. I'm not sure if his E was available at the time. Again, these are bugged. But it's possible he had that available. So I may not have necessarily needed to. But I'm going to back after this. This is effectively infinite mana right now. This mana means nothing to anyone. So why not burn the whimsy on him to make him move fast? And if I do, maybe that convinces him to not go back in like this. Maybe it helps him go back in harder and he still dies. Who knows? But I think nonetheless, whether or not it would have made a difference here, I think it is generally a misplay. Because with how far... Oops. Whoa, not that button. We got to remember with how far... She was clearly committed for this, right? So she came from here to here. If Ezreal instead was walking this whole time, I think he walked back about that far. If he had instead walked to here... Okay, maybe she's not able to land the charm quite yet. But if she takes that ultimate, that's a long ultimate. Sure, she might miss out on some damage. But if she takes another one of those charges and charges right over here, I think that's about the same size, she's suddenly right next to Ezreal. So even if Ezreal had been playing optimally and were here, he would maybe after a full charge, maybe would be here. Maybe could have walked through the minions, got here. He's still incredibly in a danger zone right now and probably likely would die from that because he's outmatched in levels and might not have his E up. So I'm probably safe. If I can get him towards me, we can probably fend her off together. Maybe. Maybe. But if I had given him that whimsy and he was already running, he might all the way be back here or back here. And if he is, that one mitigates the damage off of this charge. If he's on the further side, it mitigates the damage off of this charge. And most importantly, it makes her use her last charge just to get in range to fight. Right? So sure, maybe I can't make her become a bunny when she's here. But I shouldn't think about trying to wait until she's already on top of us and then how's the best way to play. I need to think about what's the best way to play it right now. Now that we see that she's here, what do? We need to run. What helps us run? Whimsy helps us run. Once we're here, if we're fighting in the thick of it like that, I'll shield. You know? I think these were still on cooldown at the time, so don't let your eyes deceive you here. But I'll shield them. I'll throw my Q out. Hopefully that's enough, you know? Unfortunately, that's not the way it goes down. Ezreal's forward. He's just a little caught off guard, I think. With the ignite and the last auto, she gets him. Fortunately, I do get hit by the charm, but I'm Lulu. I have the power of the whimsy, which I wish I'd given to Ezreal, so I'm fine. She decides to back off, so nothing more comes of that. So I think that's definitely willingness to... You can see the window shopping there. I think that's willingness to use cooldowns. And not as much... let's go back a little bit, because we jumped ahead too far. Oops. It's not as much as before. The problem was map awareness. I think this was... like cooldown greed or mana greed. So we're back here. Nothing comes of that. They don't end up finding an opportunity to get us there. So Ezreal's just going to farm this out. We'll go ahead and speed this up. Blitz is clearing out my pink ward. Okay. I don't want to go too far forward because I didn't have vision of Mordekaiser the whole time. It's okay. Play safe. Just let him clear the pink ward. Just one red ward. It's fine. Let's go back. Get some harass damage in. We'll reward that when we can. They're pushing, so we'll just wait till it's pushed. Wait till we clear it out after the minion stops. I was hoping that they would aggro to me so Ezreal wouldn't take damage, but... Now would be a good time to throw that ward because we see that Rengar isn't here. So it's pretty clear, especially once Mordekaiser shows up and is still over here. Would be a free opportunity to ward there. And I do have my trinket available and a red ward I can throw down there. Unfortunately, he lands a hook. Not much to that aside from I just got hooked there, you know? I don't think there's much to say about that one. Yeah. I thought I was further back, or like further in line with these minions than I was. And maybe that does go back to the lesson yesterday of positional awareness. And it's so unfortunate. And I do so much damage to Ezreal. That's just so bad. Oh, yay. Yeah, I think that's yesterday's lesson in a nutshell. Positional awareness. I just need to be more aware of where my enemies are in relation to me, what abilities they have, what sort of like hitbox line they have. And Blitz is a hard one to judge. You know, it goes further than you think. So, I'm not going to be able to get there in time for anything. I'm gonna whimsy myself. So get here, try and farm this out, try and shove them off. Primarily, just trying to get as much damage on there. Once this battle happens, I knew I had my ultimate available, so I was hoping that we could I could bait out a fight underneath the turret. It worked out. We get the heal for free out of it. I want to see if there's a way I could have played it better, though. So right here, I'm kind of standing behind the minions, kind of half not. I want to... My thinking at the time, at least, right, was to be as far forward as possible to bait Mordekaiser to start off, because then he would draw the aggro of the turret. Because with that little of HP, if he takes any turret damage, he's going to be dead. Unfortunately, I extend a little bit too far this way. And Blitz, even though it comes out of his right arm, as Riot so often reminds us, it's going to be enough of a hitbox to where going in front of the minion, it'll still grab me. So Blitz will start off with the aggro here. Which, okay, whatever. I still think baiting a fight like this is the right decision. Blitz draws aggro, so what do I do, right? Mordekaiser already has the AoE thrown out. So I'm afraid of his bonk, primarily. The question is, who should I turn into a bunny here? Who gets the polymorph? Is it Blitzcrank because I want him to not be able to run out of the turret quickly enough to drop aggro in time? Or is it Mordekaiser to try and mitigate the damage? I think at this point I'm just so suddenly afraid of my life, thinking I had miscalculated this, I'm just spamming armor myself. Which is the right thing to do to start. I want to be close enough to hit the knockup on both of them, because once my body's size is like that large, once I ulti myself, and the knockup range, is just the immediate area around. So I want to try and get the knockup onto Blitzcrank if I can as well. And since Mordekaiser is standing right on top of me, like, these AoE circles are going to do damage regardless. So there's no, like, moving towards Blitzcrank slightly, there's no opportunity cost to that. I'm going to lose the same amount of HP from these circles as if I didn't. You know, what's he, like, maybe he gets an auto in, might be something, but he's running right now. He's turning from the turret. So, unfortunately, I only hit it on one. He got far enough back, since he backed all the way out here, before, I think this was as soon as the silence ended. So, even with a ring like this, if I had been a bit more forward, instead of going like this, I went like that, the ring still probably would have only been here. So, I wouldn't have hit Blitz. So, I think it's alright. Seeing him have gone back, waiting for the silence to expire. Okay. Let's just ult ourselves in a safer location. So this is fine. Blitz maintained the aggro, even though he went that high. He didn't drop the aggro, which is actually a masterful play by him, I think. And he's going to get his shield proc here. Not here. I just don't have any damage really output. Glitter Lance goes out. I think I hit Mordekaiser. I'm not sure if I hit Blitz with it. Blitz tanks the last shot, and maybe his passive was already down. Again, it doesn't really show because the timers are bugged here. So I guess that's the most I could have got out of that. There's not really much more to have done there. So I guess I'm fine with that. And I don't want to play too greedy, you know, especially when we're not already winning the lane. We're already behind in the lane. So whatever. Ari comes up and kills me now. Oh, actually, no, I survive here. Just barely. But here's the real punish, right? Don't worry, we're not going to skim over that quickly. Because that's the real punish, right? We have no vision. No vision of Ari. There's no Mia ping, but it doesn't matter. Because I can see the map too. There's no vision of Ari. Now, we know from what just happened, she's here. She's ready to kill me. But currently, I don't know that. We have no vision of where she is. So, what's important here to me as an individual, right? Should I be thinking about, again, looking at the map, saying this fog of war, everyone that we don't see is on the edge of it. Rengar, he's in this bush and try. You know, he's in this river brush right here. Ahri, she's in try. She's on the edge of the fog of war waiting to ult in to try and get me, you know? Or do I want to just assume that that's not the case and do what? Maybe get some additional damage on these minions, pick up the gold that's lying on the ground when they're about to die. As soon as I see this, I realize I have made a grave error. So once I'm in this situation, I think that's the main lesson here, is this map awareness, right? And he pings it out as soon as he can, but, like, he realizes it as soon as she's out of the fog of war. So it's too late. The problem is, I wasn't playing around that because I wasn't having proper map awareness, right? Once I'm in this situation, I'm trying to path as like far away from her as possible and cheat in and out of the brush to see if I can make it so her ulti charge doesn't hit me, it goes to one of these minions, or if she throws down her E, the E's will go to the minions first. So I think that was good use. And also I try and go a little bit more like towards the wall to hopefully dodge the charm instead of going in a straight line. I was thinking the straight line would be a little bit more predictable. She just went right for where I was, so I might have actually counterintuitively been able to dodge. If I was probably in an arc like this, I would probably be right here. Charm has a pretty generous hitbox, so maybe not even then. But the most important thing in this situation is right here, this exhaust. Get it down before the charm, before the Q, before her other charges, so that's good. So I'm able to get the charm or the exhaust out in time. I get hit by the charm. All this is exhausted. As soon as the charm ends, I flash. I flash not directly towards the turret, but as close towards the turret as I can while hugging the wall, because Blitz is here. This is good positional awareness. Not to toot my own horn, it's just, again, the lesson from last episode was positional awareness. So this is good. This is good positional awareness. Trying to stand back. He actually throws it pre-flash, so it's fine, it didn't matter. Ari kind of goes a little bit too far. She had gone closer. The damage from that charge, she's trying to dodge the turret aggro, like I understand the turret cone. She's trying to stay out of it. If she had just gone even from like here to here, just directly on top of me, she probably kills me with that charge, maybe like an auto. So I might have been dead there. I'm lucky. I make it out alive. Especially with her ignite, right? If she gets that ulti charge off on me and ignites me, even with the shield, I'm done. So definitely right to shield myself as soon as I can, as soon as it's off cooldown. And just run. Don't try and get any autos in. Don't do anything cute. Luckily, I wind up surviving. Ezreal does his thing. Not worried about that. This is a decision point, right? So I see Gragas is there. And he's coming. It's like, okay. Seeing that Ezreal has backed so far off. Seeing that, let's actually back up just a little bit, right? Right here. Okay? So I'm thinking, alright, I've clicked my little rally point over here. I'm either gonna live or I'm not. I'm popping the biscuit, you know. So I'm watching the fight, seeing what's gonna happen. Ari is far, far away. She's got no ultimate. She's got low HP, right? Gosh darn it. Give me that click. She's got most of her HP gone. Blitz is even further away. Gragas is coming right behind me. Fresh out of base. Full everything. Malphite. AP Malphite, remember. Burst you in one shot, Malphite. He's got full everything, both summoners. He's coming on the flank, right? So he's going to be popping out of here looking to finish somebody. And just his ultimate kills either of them, really. If he can get both of them, he gets both of them. So, do I base here? Or do I try and go in and help Ezreal? I don't think that they need me, per se. But we got to remember, and I'm saying I was calculating this at the time, but we got to remember, we don't know where top is. Top has TP. It's entirely... Oh, I can't click there. Top, there we go, has TP. Top could be here at any moment, right here. You know? Full health, has Kale ultimate available. So that means these people are not squishy. You know, they're not able to be one shot. They are able to tank AP Malphite's entire combo, and then AP Malphite is this squishy giant minion that does nothing, that doesn't even auto attack very hard. We don't know where the jungler is, ostensibly, right? Let's say I wasn't paying attention and tracking his movement throughout the fog of war, because I wasn't. So Okay, I'm very at risk of death if I survive this, which I now know I just did. I don't have any summoners, but I still have ultimate. Right? Maybe? That can't possibly be right. I think I've just been talking too long. Nonetheless, I have these cooldowns. I want to enable Ezreal to get around that fight where he needs to be to gap close on these people. So I want to go back in. Since I'm sensing that the fight is hanging or is continuing, I hang around trying to bait them back, right? I'm eating the biscuits to make sure I don't just get one shot out of Fog of War, right? Throwing down vision where I can, because, you know, hey, if I'm going back to base, might as well at least use my Sightstone charges. I'm hanging around Gragas. I'm not even going to take the popcorn plant. I'm just, like, staying as close to him as possible. Make sure I don't get hit from Fog of War. This is okay, even though I need to act like this is Fog of War Rengar Bush, because Rengar just revealed himself, right? So we can go in here, drop that ward, safe. We know Rengar's here. I can run back down. I want to make sure I don't get anywhere within of a Rengar brush, right? I want to make sure I'm supporting Ezreal, though, because I know Rengar's around. Mordekaiser's back here. I threw down the sweeper in this brush, just on the off chance it was warded. Because if somebody extends too far, we can now get him. Gragas cancels his recall. I don't think anyone was in vision yet. I was watching on the minimap, I didn't see anyone pop into vision. But so I cancel my recall and stick with him, right? It's that old adage of, like, you know, if you're going to do something, commit to it fully, do it right. I'm out of biscuits. I hope I was out of biscuits, at least I was. So we're looking to just try and make somebody blow up, if possible. Now we see Rengar, okay? We were thinking, all right, my mouth's watering a little bit, because we see Mordekaiser there. You know, Mordekaiser walking into the bush, we just swept it. It's fine. Maybe we can make something happen. Ezreal's right there. Ezreal's kind of far enough back to where he wouldn't immediately be in this fight, but he does have E, right? So he could Arcane Shift here and already be Mystic Shotting, because he's incredibly long-ranged Ezreal, right? But this is a poor position overall, because he would have to do all that just to get in range of Mystic Shot. So the safe zone is, like, here for our engagement with Ezreal, right? This is, like, all covered. But we're actually kind of getting pincered. Even though it's 2-on-2, I'm a support with basically no health. And this is a jungler who, early enough in the game, doesn't really have that much damage, that much combat stats, right? He has a move speed smite. Doesn't really matter that much. He has runic echoes. Okay, that'll deal a lot of damage. And a cloth armor. Yeah, whatever. It's not too much. And I have, like, theoretically tanky stats, but it doesn't matter because I have no health left. A little bit of damage. Okay, whatever. A little bit of damage. Fine. This is too dangerous. Rengar has a lot of damage. Right? Like, he even has the red smite, you know? Mordekaiser has Sheen to proc. He's got combat, not just, you know, a cloth armor sitting by itself. He has combat stat effective itemization against both of us. The only thing we are, the way we get him, when we get either of these guys, is we chain CC properly. He's already got the CC boots of the Merc Treads, because I have Wednesdayed him too many times in lane for him to be okay with dealing with that anymore. So this is not really a trap for Mordekaiser once Rengar is here. And that map awareness of knowing where Ezreal is in relation to us is what I needed to have more of. So let's see how this works out, right? So we see him getting the fruit. Mordekaiser's back to lane. Ezreal's still here doing his thing. He's regen to full. He's the one in here. We actually... he sweeps us. Uh-oh. But that's the go button, right? I don't think I was aware of this situation, this dynamic at all. I was so focused, I was so tunnel visioned here. Because I knew I was low health, I knew we had to make this work if we were going to go for it. So we started off well. I hold the Glitter Lance until the Body Slam CC wears off. Okay, good. Good start. That's the Courage of Colossus Shield, so I haven't used my own. And we get a free flash. Great. Great, it all works out. Ezreal is in base because he completed the recall. Because he was channeling recall, and I saw that. If Rengar didn't leave, okay, sure, we got the jump on him. But, like, we have cooldowns now, and he still has all of his. Mordekaiser can just rotate right on up and bonk us to death, you know? If he doesn't flash, and if Mordekaiser comes up to back him up, I die here. They maybe get a kill on to, a return kill onto Rengar, but, like, if Gragas stays long enough to try and get that return kill, because Gragas, okay, yeah, again, he has a Runic Echoes, he does some damage. But that will probably mean he's around trying to do enough persistent damage long enough to where Mordekaiser might get a kill on him and it becomes a 2-for-1. I think this was actually a really bad play. It worked out for us. I think I had poor map awareness there, resulting in a bad play. Way too risky for no reason. Worked out. Okay. Didn't get punished. Nice. Feels good. Don't think that was good. Think that was bad. Try and get that farm. If I can, go back to base. Walk my ass back to base. So at this point, Ezreal's died to the turret. The turret had no HP left, so I'm just gonna hang back here, right? And this is good with my map awareness of how we don't control our own jungle right now. So why am I going forward? Why am I going forward to just see the minions? To just watch the turret die in front of me? Oh, okay. So I stop and come back. That's a good example of my map awareness being put to good use. Okay, good. So I hang out. I let the minions come to me. I was thinking, all right, let me try and just be in push mode. But then, no, I actually want to freeze it. So I Glitter Lance there to last hit him. But then I try and, like, freeze and don't do anything. I could push out and try and see this dragon. But we don't have vision of mid. We don't have vision of bot. We have some vision in the jungle from my deep wards earlier, but it hasn't revealed anything. So they are on this dragon. There's nothing we can do to contest that. We got to assume there's four of them there. Or there's four of them waiting to bushwhack me. You know? Ari's waiting to charm and Rengar pounce and just fucking kill me immediately. So, again, a good example of map awareness, instead of being like, oh, I'm a support, let me go walk into the fog of war and war for no goddamn reason. I just sit here and pick up the gold that's going to fall on the ground. Or at least I try to, right? Get these last hits. Okay, some extra gold. Kind of hug that once I have minions here, and I know Ezreal's right here, so even if I did get bushwhacked, I could maybe, like, jump away, flash away, whimsy myself, shield myself, ulti myself, something like that. Careful. As far back as possible. Ward that, just on the edge. Okay, nobody's there. Walk a little forward. Okay, dragon's down. And it's Mordekaiser. Again, it's Mordekaiser, so we know they're doing dragon. We know they're doing dragon. Dragon's gone. Okay. Pause there thinking, no, what am I warding for? We know they have dragon. We know Mordekaiser was with them. There's no reason to ward right now. I'm going to rotate top. Or rotate mid. Ward this on the way out. 2v1 happening right now. I'm not sure why I would do this. Because it would slow me down. And I felt this in the moment, right? I think it was just I wasn't really aware that these two were here. That these two were here at the time. So I stopped to auto. Because I was going to try and maybe like get a little bit vision of this area through this brush. In that brush. But once they're here, I need to just keep going. I kind of split the baby and half kept going by only autoing it where I immediately was. So the cone went out like this, like you're seeing. And then I could keep going. But at this point, once we see these two, there's no reason to hit this. I need to just move. I need to just go and get there to try and support Mouth. Or even decide, like, hey, all of this is too risky because these two can come just right across this wall, either using her charm, and then he just AoEs over the wall and she ults over, or they use some flashes they might have up. Not worth it. That's fine. But I need to be moving here. I should be on the edge of this right now. I'm not. I get zoned. Maybe I don't get zoned. Whatever. Didn't matter. It was fine. This is just Blitz, as far as I know. Ahri's still, like, on this Fog of War. Luckily, he doesn't land the Q. I'm spending my time clearing out that vision. Try to give those really the last hit so he can get that. That's fine. My shield's already down, so I can't shield him. We see the dragon. That's the first time I actually see the dragon. It's like, okay, it's for sure here. I knew it was around here somewhere with that leash range for Mordekaiser, but now we actually see it. They're for sure coming to mid. So I gotta hang out here. Gragas is looking for the flank. He unfortunately gets lucky. I'm able to get the my ultimate off on him. Knocks up three. Pretty good. Still dead. Still dead. Might not have been worth it to ultimate in there. Could have been better to save it for somebody else. We do get a knock up on three, so it slows them down and delays the follow-up engage. So they can't just like, okay, well, Gragas is dead now. Let's immediately all turn on a Malphite, who, remember, is super squishy, right? Like, he's Morello pen boots, you know? He's got regen, but he's got no survivability. So, okay. Unfortunate. Maybe there was an opportunity for us to go all in here and get some kills with how much damage he could output. Maybe not. I don't know AP Malph's potential that well. I'm gonna be honest with you, Twitch chat. I don't know what AP Malph can do damage-wise, because I don't play AP Malph. So okay, I threw my ultimate down there. Seeing that the dragon timed out this early, maybe we could have been a bit further forward, putting out some damage, trying to shove them off this turret, right? At this point, you realize that we definitely should have been more forward, because this flank happened, right? Fizz came around on the flank. And it's one of those devastating Fizz flanks where it's like, oh god, a Fizz who did decent in lane is behind us with a big fish. So we need to set up for this, plain and simple. And I think this comes down to, I think we've found the theme, right? Whole time, there's Fizz. We see him coming. This is the point where we can tell he's committing to the flank because he's not coming through here. He's not coming through the safely warded red ward control ward brush, either taking this path or that path. He's coming through lane. This is, I'm coming through lane. We're fighting. We're going to turn this around. We're going to get some kills. I'm fucking Fizz. So immediately, okay, up to this point, whatever. But immediately here, this is where we are. I've gone all the way. Oops, I actually just tapped the screen over. Let me hold on. Ah, there we go. I actually just walked all the way back and then forward a little bit. Right? I could have instead walked pretty much anywhere in this zone I could be right now. Right? I could be anywhere in this zone. If I'm right here. You know, maybe they throw out some harass on me. I'm full health. I have all my mana. I don't have my cooldown on my ultimate, sure. But I have my summoners. And I have a Fizz about to come and destroy your backline. Okay. Again, same situation. Maybe I don't do it because the dragon's up. Dragon's gonna tank the turret. Dragon's gonna output a lot of damage. Okay, fine. Dragon expires? Dragon dies on its own? I gotta go forward. I gotta move. I gotta move. From right here, I need to be right here. I need to be autoing these champions. Whoever the turret aggros, I need to focus. I need to be turning people into bunnies. I need to be throwing out glitter lance on people. There's so much to do. So much that's not done. There's even delayed entering a little bit. But then he's like, look, this turret's gonna die. I gotta go. He throws out the fish. We are all still backing off. Forget all, because I can't control other people, right? If just in this last little bit, if I had gone here, I'm in a position right now to throw Glitter Lance slow too. Because they're already being slowed by this, or at least Rengar is. I'm in a position to whimsy one of these people and make them become a bunny. You know? It's not working out. It's not happening. So instead, Fizz has to initiate alone. Again, even just that little bit. If I'm, instead of being here, I'm here right now. Rengar's already dead. Like, I could Glitter Lance auto him to death. So that means Fizz could go onto the double buff Mordekaiser. Wonderful. Give Fizz our double buffs, right? Or their double buffs, rather. Even better, give him their double buffs. This guy would be dead. Would be easy. We could get a double kill right there. That totally makes this worth. That turns this whole fight around. We get a double instead. Instead, he has to focus Rengar. Blitz is low. We do end up getting Blitz too, right? Now we're chasing. That's so much damage from AP Malphite that we end up getting another. But look who gets away. Look who gets away. If I had helped, if I had had better map awareness, if I had positioned myself more properly with that map awareness, I could have been further forward. Fizz could have started by taking out Mordekaiser, and this would be 4-for-1. That's maybe 2 turrets? Maybe 1 turret Rift Herald? Something. Instead, we have another engage that has to happen. Malphite just ults him, plain, straight out with Unstoppable Force and one-shots him. That was really fun to watch. So then we're able to try and go for this turret. We don't end up getting it. Rengar is ulting. So I'm trying to stay grouped. I throw the shield down on Fizz because he's most likely to get jumped on. Then we just all stay on top of each other. We're fine. It turns out he went on our tanky jungler. It's fine. Not a problem. Trying to throw out some vision control here. Leash the scuttle crab a little bit. Looking for a way to get back in here. Saw Blitz blocking my path. Don't risk it. Gragas does, though. And because I went this way, instead of hovering here, okay, Blitz positions here, I position back here. But I need to hover in this area overall. Because I saw Gragas coming around, right? Whether or not I agree with this play, it doesn't matter. Proper thing to do, seeing that this play is happening, is to be here. So when this does come out, I can go in a little bit, give him a shield, give him whimsy, give him something, make somebody a bunny, do something. Instead, down here, he has to blow his ultimate just to get himself out alive, right? So I effectively give them a free Gragas ultimate there by not being in proper position to support him out. And maybe he would have gotten an ultimate that would have broke them apart and sent one forward and two back, and maybe we could have got a kill off that if he could have used his ultimate more properly and didn't have to use it to get out himself. Maybe not. Maybe it was a poor engage. Maybe it was a good engage. Maybe I missed an opportunity there because I had bad map awareness. We get another kill here. Because AP Malphite and Fizz are doing AP Malphite and Fizz things. I get pulled into the brush here. Let's actually analyze this a little bit. Let's run up top. We have the speed shrine. Malphite's here behind me. We know Rengar's dead. Okay? We see Ahri's over here. We don't know who's around here, though. Could be Blitz and Mordekaiser. Right? Spooky. Malph's a little bit far away from me. Maybe if Malphite was already here. Maybe it's definitely if Malphite was here. I'm clear to go up here. Because then we're forming a pincer. Right? Whoever's in this bush, if it is two of them, hey, that's fine. We got you. If it's their whole bot lane, mid and support, we're fine. We still got you. And Fizz is closer. Our Fizz is closer than Kale. So even if it's not 100% decisive, we got you. Instead, he's a lot further back. So this is a bit too much. I kind of dance a little bit here, but then I go straight in. And he's turning to go even deeper, right? Maybe in part from my willingness to go so immediately into that bush. So I'm disincentivizing him to join me here and pincer this properly. So I get pulled out of Fog of War. Luckily, it's just Blitz, so it's okay. He gets a kill on Ahri. Wonderful. So all that resulted in was a kill on Ahri, really. But it could have been much worse. It could have been much worse. Once he's coming in on the flank, gotta know that unstoppable force is coming. So I gotta be ready to back them up a little bit more. I was too far back. And I don't think I had the map awareness. Sorry to always harbor on the phrase once we identify it. But I don't think I saw him when he was in this range. I just don't think I was paying attention and saw him on the minimap. Malphite goes in so fast, I gotta be able to see that happening as it's coming up, right? I didn't actually know he DC'd there. He was just leaving. It's alright. I'm thinking Blitz is around, so we need to back off. Get it if we can. Back off if we can. Fine. Do a little sweep. Hang out just in case he needs me. Doesn't look like he needs me, so I think fine. Fortunately, Rengar is here to ult. So problems start happening. I didn't know that was happening when I backed though, so I think that was fine. I think this is actually out of my control, right? They do end up getting him. That sucks. I was just hanging out in base the whole time. I don't think there's much that can really be done about that. Maybe I could have hung out just saying that because this turret here is down, right? Since we don't have that turret, this is too risky for one person, even if it seems to be 1v1. So maybe I should wait and like soak XP with him, support him while he's farming, and then escort him back to a safe recall location. Maybe that's the right call. Again, map awareness would have helped me make that call. Even though it seems fine. No vision of anybody. No vision of anybody. Even though we have this ward here, this is all Fog of War. All of that is Fog of War, right? Their whole team could be anywhere there. And we know they're not mid and bot. So they could really, he could really use an escort. He could use somebody to support him farming out of the lane to get that last little push out, you know? Maybe I support him. Maybe they don't get this kill here. I don't have the map awareness to recognize that that was a possibility, so I don't even consider the play. So now I come here as quickly as I can. Fight's largely already happened. Now fight's just beating my face in. Ouch. The betrayal. You know, that flash makes me smile. Not sure how necessary that ultimate was. There's a bush here. Rengar could hop to it. Or could have gone quicker to it so he could be hopping already. Probably wasn't the most necessary thing. But I don't know how tanky this Fizz is. Because this Fizz is going more on the damagey side, right? Whatever he builds this into, it's going to be proto-belt, looks like. He hasn't really built it yet, so he's got a little bit of health from Kindle's Gem, a little bit of magic resistance, but physical damage, physical damage. I think this counts as physical damage. Mixed damage. So, hold him to be safe. Again, one of the previous lessons we were thinking about was cooldowns, specifically with summoner spells, and this was a minor point. The whole lesson wasn't on this, but trying to be more liberal about using summoner spells also applies to using the ultimate as well. I'm Lulu. I got a fairly low cooldown on my ultimate. I build cooldown reduction items. It's fine. I think that was the right play to... I think it was an acceptable play, rather. Maybe not the right play, but an acceptable play to ult him just to be safe there. Rotating down bottom, because I think that's the most targetable lane. Even though, like, we have an outer turret up here, they were all just up here. We're going to be creating pressure mid, so that will allow bot to shove in and really try and take this objective hard, because we can rotate back down to bot. And mid feels like the most pressing thing right here. Blue buffs available. Okay, maybe we don't even try for this. Maybe we just take blue buffs, especially since Ezreal's recalling, right? So I go here. Can't get that cleared out. Was that actually a scrying? I am interested. Because this is like Malphite doing Malphite things. No, this was just vision given from that. So I just didn't get there in time. Didn't grab the red ward. Not really doing much for them right now, regardless. Put a little bit of extra damage in him. Try not to take the kill here. He flashes. He makes it out. Well, not really. We have AP Mouth. So he's dead. But, trying to be a little too nice there. Trying to feed off the kill. The whole reason he was so close to dying, and the reason all it took was that little flash disc, was because I was putting out the damage. I wasn't holding back earlier. So I need to be a little bit more willing to take the last hit on a champion so we don't have to burn flash. If Malphite, AP Malphite, has his flash up, that's going to be a whole world of hurt late game. This whole time this flash cooldown's up. My fault. Plays are being missed. We end up getting killed there. Good. I think going forward here is bad. Right? Maybe at least once I'm here, going this far forward and then coming back on top of it. Again, think of that. She knows because she just saw Rengar that they're in this brush, so this brush isn't really deceiving anyone of anything. So I could have gone instead, even if I had just started from where I'm at now. Without doing that loop, I could be all the way back here. I'm here. I whimsy Malphite. He gets in there. He gets a slow and a bunch of damage. And she can't get away. You know? Seeing that Fizz was coming... Here, hold on. Let me put that on a red. What the heck is going on here? Party was disbanded. Oh, here. Oh, wait. There we go. Seeing that this was on red, right? Or it was on red, sorry. Seeing that this Fizz was coming from top side, or from the mid lane, the top side of the frame we have right now, I gotta be matching him. I should be as close to the point of interest right here. Well, the Ahri is obviously the target, right? But I should be as close to the point of interest, the point of conflict, as he is. So that means I need to be around here. So that whole extra loop I did, wasted time. Because I didn't see Fizz there. I didn't have proper map awareness. So instead, Ahri's gonna get away. Give me one sec, guys. I just wanna let them know why I'm ignoring. Okay. So, instead, we're not able to make a play. Gragas feels... Now, it looks like, okay, well, Gragas would have ulted him away anyway, and he would have been fine, right? No, because Gragas feels he has to open up with his ultimate. Otherwise, she's going to get away. And he's right, because she has Spirit Rush up, right? So he has to open up with that. If instead, maybe I was in better positioning because of my map awareness, I could have maybe helped out. We could have had Malphite open up. I could have whimsied him to speed him up, and he could have slowed Ahri. And then that would have been an easier ultimate for Gragas to hit. Then Fizz could have taken a more aggressive path. You know? He could have playful trickstered here and made it before she was ulted. Because this is post the ult, right? If we just didn't ult her away, she's still right here. Fizz can gap close with playful trickster to here by the time she's on top of this ward. And then she's in trouble because he can just Q right to her. A lot of what ifs, but it's all possible if I had better positioning because of my map awareness. But I don't have good map awareness. I didn't even know Fizz was here until, like, this point, right? Until I saw him pinging, you know? So, she gets ulted away. She makes it out for free. I burn another cooldown. And again, worst case scenario, right? Think of it just as the cooldown. All we did was lose Gragas cooldown there. That's so key for our team fight. We really need that. So just by my poor map awareness, I wasted our key team fight mechanism. We're still going for this. Big Fish comes out. Unfortunately, can't make it. That slow comes out, chunks her quite a bit because AP Malphite is crazy. Not much else comes of it. We back away. Figuring we can't get much more. She's kiting a little bit. Grog says, you're being too greedy. Now again, remember, he has that ultimate available from earlier. He didn't have to use that. She's dead. That's a dead Ahri. Instead, she's fine. I could have been a little bit closer to Gragas. And actually, I think this is a really good point, too, about Mount Bornus, right? It's because right here, right? She's going to come this way, and Gragas turns it, like, here. And body slams. He actually stops right here to bait it. That's beautiful. I should be backing him up. Like, she is alone. We have enough vision to know that she is way out of position to be playing this aggressively. Like, now there's somebody here. There's somebody, like, right here, a Rengar in that brush. This is too far forward for her. I need to be turning back, and I need to be throwing out my slow from my Glitter Lance, or turning her into a bunny. We're still backing so far away, Gragas can't even take that belly slam. He was looking for it right there. He keeps walking away. She walks forward. He turns. Again, we're so far away right now. Even if it was just in the brush, right? I'm just still right here. Because whatever, after this ward goes down, I want to be hidden in Fog of War in the brush. Fine. If I'm right here instead of right here, that much distance is going to make all the difference in the world here. Right? That Glitter Lance misses. Instead of being right here, I'd be right here. If then I Glitter Lance, that Glitter Lance hits, right? Because as soon as that body slam hit, there wouldn't have been an opportunity to do it from the distance I was at. Why? Because my map awareness. So focused on the ward, I wasn't paying attention to elsewhere on the map. I wasn't seeing how close Ahri and Gragas were to each other. That would have made this dragon completely free. Instead, still completely free. But, theoretically, there could have been a problem there. I'm lucky, so there wasn't. Run back as quickly as I can. Don't get there in time for any of this action. Whatever, fine. Moving right along. Kale being badass. I love that Aether Wing Kale skin. Forward! So, I saw that ward, thought better of it. Whatever. I'll get it next rotation. Might as well sweep out Baron Pit. Make sure we have vision control over that. I actually saw that on the map because I have good map awareness sometimes. And knew, okay, somebody's taking the Silk Road path back through here. Especially when that person popped out near Fizz. I think it was Mordekaiser. And I was like, okay, they probably warded Baron. We need to be aware of that. I think I even said it in chat. Throw the pink, the red ward down just to check for that. Okay, still clear. So we could theoretically do this. Decide not to. Decide to go for top lane. Save for objective. Go here, take out the blast gun along the way. Supporting Gragas. Knew the Rengar was there because I had good map awareness there. Trying to hold the minions here to allow our minions to get in. Take this aggro and not aggro to the minions themselves. They can all focus the turret. That'll help Azrael knock it down quicker. Good map awareness there. Rengar's down here. That's it. That's all we know. Okay. Just looking for a little poke. We have some decent vision. There's a little bit of question about here. But again, Rengar was just here. And now we see Kayle is recalling. Right? So that means we have at least a little bit of time before she can use her TP. Because she wants to go back before she TPs in at a minimum. Right? So we're okay. He takes this brush. It makes us a lot safer. We've got a lot of vision here. If Kayle starts TPing in, we'll probably see it. Pretty safe. Now we're leaving some of that vision, but we have an opportunity to destroy it, right? But then Rengar ults. Now we have no idea where Rengar is, because he was mid. He was here, right? He was around here at a minion wave. But now he could be anywhere there. Could be way out of screen, right? Not good. Not the time to dive. Now, if it was a super squishy guy, hey, maybe we could burst him. Let's build Triforce. He's built Merc Treads. He's got a little bit of tankiness to him. I mean, he has a nominal amount of health from Outfield, right? He's tanky enough to where this probably isn't the quickest burst dive. Especially when he's got minions here, and we don't. We're not going to be getting a lot of support. We're going to be having trouble weaving our skill shots in from Ezreal. My Glitter Lance is going to be hitting, or my picks damage is going to be hitting some of these. Not the cleanest time to dive. Decide to back off. Does Gragas, right? I whimsy him just in case Gragas is going for it. But I think this is the right call. It's time to back off. Fortunately, Gragas is kind of dancing around there. Whatever. We saw the Rengar is right here. And if I had good map awareness, I would have saw that as well. They target Gragas because now there's two of them, right? Again, this is why it was so risky. All this fog of war that we didn't have view of, well, it turns out Ahri was right there, you know? So now Gragas is going to take damage. Luckily for us, Gragas has become a tanky man. He's the tankiest tanks of tanks. Not really, because he has runic echoes, but he's getting there, right? He's going to be all right. I can't do anything. Glitter Lance doesn't even reach. I do get there in time to throw my ult on him. He flashes away. It's fine. I position myself way too far forward. And I'm able to throw down the exhaust onto Ahri. Okay. Not so bad. Right here we have Fizz coming in starting to do horrible, scary Fizz things because he's the highest level person here. He out-levels Ahri by 4 levels. Ugh. He's going to be a terror. And I've got an exhaust on Ahri, who's going after a tank. Probably going to be okay. Not quite sure about the turn, but that's fine. But now I'm in the danger zone. She can turn on me. Luckily, we burst her. Can't quite get much more. Fish misses, but Fizz OP. Give him the Lindsay to get out of there. Good. Staying here to siege the turret might not be the right call. But since these two are here, I do need to stay here. So getting some poke. Oh, that's fine. Alright. And I'm happy to leave. Sweep it out on my way. Comment to the live chat how good Ezreal is for trying to proc his cooldown along the way. Keep stacking that tier. Okay, so we have an engagement going on here. Malphite trying to blow up Ahri one-shotter. Beautiful. Great. Do that. Rengar's ulting in. As soon as he gets the kill, he leaves. I throw the shield onto Fizz. I don't think I whimsied him. No, I didn't. But now I'm way out of position, right? And I'm so out of position, I see Rengar, right? This is the death ball. And these are... Well, he just flashed, so maybe he's a little bit more vulnerable. Fizz, because of this exact thing, nobody wants to ever go after. But hey, this is going to be on cooldown now. You know, maybe they're targetable. But boy, am I a good target. I had ulted Gragas back up here in this engagement. I threw my shield down onto Fizz, so shortly ago, it's still on, like it's showing the animation for it. Oh boy, I'm a good target. And I'm running through brushes. So I'm gonna die. I'm gonna die here to Rengar. Whimsy, not enough. Dead. Dead, unanswered. Dead. Telling you right now, this fight I'm not aware of. Fine, whatever. Now I need to be aware of this. I see Fizz. That's what I see. Don't see this. Okay. If I had full vision of this... Okay. These guys can't be stopped. Kale's ultimate is on cooldown. Wonderful. He has the passive shield. Not up right now, but it builds up. Rengar's full health ulting. Kale has a heal and is basically full health. This is something we need to get away from. Evac immediately. I've thrown my shield down on him. If he's in range, I'll whimsy him. These two got to evac this way. And I've got to evac this way. We got to run right now. I go forward. Look how far forward I went. Do you see how far forward I went? I went from here to here. That whole distance. If instead I had gone this way, I'd already be leaving this bush. I could then go here and blast cone out and create distance by going over that wall, right? I could be gone. Gone. Rengar doesn't get me. 100% of the time I get out of there. For free. Guaranteed I get out of there alive. I don't. I walk forward like that. Why? Didn't realize he was there. Didn't realize Kale was backing him up. Didn't realize they were all full health. Didn't have the map awareness for it. And then Kale gets to use a popcorn plant to get away. I should have used that blast cone to get away. Yeah. Gotta remember. Fizz was fed. Yeah. Luckily we're okay. He does wind up going down two. But that makes it a 2-for-2. Should have been a 2-for-1. Probably could have kept Fizz alive if I were alive. You know? Said I was dead. Instead, it started off as a deficit, and Fizz had to come back. Had to carry back. So we're pressuring bot lane. They just got a kill on Ahri. Wonderful. The dragon still got 45 seconds, right? So this isn't the priority. This is the priority objective. I'm thinking, all right, let me help Gragas shove up mid. He's the jungler. We can then rotate back because this turret's already gone. Right? And I'll rotate over here. We can all rotate to Baron. Wonderful. This is the right play. Right spot to be. Go a little bit far forward. Try and give as much vision while we're getting this. The engagement's happening down here. Okay. You know, maybe it would be going better if I was there. But we're going to get the turret out of this. So that mitigates the losses here because we'll at least be getting a turret back. Okay, whatever. Focus on this. So we get this turret. Gragas starts going. I gotta follow. Immediately. Ezreal's going back because he's low. And Oon. Malphite's going back because he's low. Okay, whatever. Try and get some vision in the jungle. Try and get some jungle objectives. Where's my map awareness right now? There's danger. Danger, danger. Danger, 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 danger. I mean, this is all our vision right now. From this ward. From this ward. From my allies who are up here. Danger, danger, danger. What am I doing? Where am I? Why am I all the way over here? Let's go back. Come on. Come on, replay engine. Uh-oh. Have we crashed? Oh, disaster. What a disaster! Old team. Alright, I think we're just gonna have to relog it. Okay, no, we're fine. Woo! Close. Okay, right here. Right here. We're. Blitz is here. We're trying to take red. Gragas and Fizz have said that's what they're doing, right? Okay, let's say I'm already all the way down here. Whatever, fine. Now's the time to come back up. Come back up. Once I'm here, it'll be clear if I need to take this path or be more aggressive and take that path. I need to be coming back. This is when I'm in Pixel Brush, right? Let's go forward. So we see both Blitz and Mordekaiser are coming. I need to help them secure this. I'm going all the way out of Pixel. I ping. I'm pretty sure that was me pinging Scuttle. Because I didn't know this was happening. I have no map awareness. Look how far. I'm an entire half a screen away. Right? If I was there, could be here. Could be there. Could be there. Stopping Blitz, right? If I'm here, that kind of buffers Blitz away. Or makes him engage on me, but then the focus is me, so I can dip. Because I have probably everything right now. This red buff gets secured. Mordekaiser alone can't steal it. Or these two turn and help Blitz, but I'm Lulu, so I get away. Instead, he secures the red for himself on probably the optimal champion. Maybe Kayle's better. Maybe Rengar's better. Mordekaiser, not bad. Not bad to have it on. Worst of all, now Blitz is coming up for the flank. They are pincered right here. There's no blast cone. They can't even get away through a blast cone. They're alone. So they gotta turn and fight. Fizz makes it look possible. Because it's so fun. It's not possible. Even Fizz goes down. Even the gods bleed. Ultimate, not gonna help. And all I did was watch. Threw out, I think, a shield once. Whimsied myself. All the results of poor map awareness. If I had proper map awareness there, those two wouldn't have died. We probably would have secured red, but those two for sure wouldn't have died. Thus, they wouldn't have the initiative to take this, right? We wouldn't have had to try to steal with that. Malphite wouldn't be dead. I wouldn't be dead to Ari, which I'm like, I'm pretty sure I died to Ari here. Yeah, she kills me. Ezreal wouldn't be dead. It's effectively my entire team. An ace and a dragon for Mordekaiser. Because I didn't have map awareness all the way back here around the pit, around red buff. Full ace and a dragon, just an air dragon, but a dragon to Mordekaiser. Because I didn't have map awareness. Not to mention any summoners or ultimate cooldowns, right? Horrendous. Horrendous. That alone easily makes the difference in this fight. Or in this entire game. That's going on. End up getting killed. Blitz DCs because sometimes you get lucky. Here comes the dragon. Fizz trying to make himself look like a beast. Here I am again. Not really much going on. Whimsy him just in case he can do something about this. With the shield in case he can go in. We want this really hard, but I'm thinking about maybe Baron. Great. Now we've got the jungler. Now we can go Baron. Throw the exhaust on him. Now we're a little low. Maybe we can't Baron so easy. TP coming in. I don't see this TP coming in until we're like about right here. Then we have to split because like one of us is here and the other is here. He gets isolated because of that. I didn't know this was coming in. If I did, could have gone this way. We could have gone that way. We could have maybe found a safer retreat path. We might have both been able to get out alive. Maybe. That one's hard to tell. There was a lot of time there. What I do know is I go in to try and ult him. Doesn't make the difference. Still dies. Probably wasn't the optimal way to play it. Probably would have found a more optimal way if I had known what was happening because I'd had map awareness. I'm hanging behind Ezreal here, throwing everything on Ezreal, trying to enable him. I'm low, so I want to hang back. Okay, good. He jumps back, so I got to stay even further behind him. Now that Ari ults in and she's targeting me because she sees how low I am, I just got to keep getting out of there. Flash. Alright, whatever, good play. I mean, some of her ultimate's wasted. Kale's ultimate kind of in the same boat. Fizz trying to be hero timing with his Ehan timing. Turns out he's fine though because he has Zonus. It's been a long day, my voice is starting to go. Attractive fight. I'm staying way in the back. Again, because I'm very low. Me and Fizz are staying in the back. I'm just trying to throw out shields onto Ezreal. Not get too close to this Ari. Throw that shield on in. Trying to stay back. Unfortunately, Fizz can't make the play because that was warded. Too bad. Whatever. I've been enabling Ezreal the whole time. That's what I'm supposed to be doing. I think that's all good. It's all well and good. Ezreal's going in deeper. I'm willing to say that we could have got more out of that if I had better map awareness of why he was going in. And the second he arcane shifted forward, if I went to get behind him quicker, we could have recovered. And the fact that we got a blitzcrank out of that, with how low this Ari is, it's entirely possible we could have got her too. I'm not going to go crazy. and say that that was a sure thing, though. Nonetheless, I should have been aware that he had shifted the second he did and got there to support him. Who knows what could happen? Warmoth Warmus, we're never going to find out. I think this means tomorrow, or next episode when I drill, I'm going to do a drill that practices Math Warmus too. This is perfect example of poor Math Warmus. Right here. So we're in only our vision, right? Mordekaiser, okay, Ari's coming too. Mordekaiser's in the riverside. Here's Ari. Ari can ult in. Now this is still big, but look at how low I am. If Ari picks off a couple kills, we might not finish this. Ari ults right in, gets me for free. Now she has to also take that, but she does, she gets me for free. I saw Ari here, and I thought, she could maybe ult me. And then before I could react, she did, and I died. Right? Okay, whatever, not that big of a deal, right? Well, you say that until the kill on her turns to a reset Baron. Now they're all so low by the time of re-aggro's. Can't do anything with that Baron. Fizz dies. They're too low to help. Gragas dies. Jungler down. Four members around Baron. They get Baron. Ezreal Steel doesn't happen. Don't get your hopes up. So, maybe if I, knowing how low I was, seeing Ahri, thinking, okay, maybe Ahri's gonna ult me. Instead of just thinking that, maybe I should realize how close she is from my map awareness, and then move away to compensate for that. Just to be safe. My auto attacks aren't doing that much, picks or no. There was no real reason for me to go crazy and be that close, put myself at such risk. They're fine. It's far more helpful for me to run in, shield somebody, run back out. Run in, shield somebody, run back out. Just that easy. Make him a bunny. I think that's good because she was already being dealt with. That's alright. Trying to get there. Doing whatever I can to help the people who are in the front. It's Fizz. They're all backing. I put myself as the tank, just in case we can start it. They didn't get there quick enough. Fortunately, it kind of baits us into getting hooked here. Fizz becomes a non-factor the whole fight. Luckily, Ezreal arcane ships away. We're okay. That judgment call, the tank there, probably wasn't the best. And, you know, it's a little bit different than our theme. It does sort of piggyback on it, because where people are backing from, because remember, they just recalled out of both top and bottom. So right now we know at least two of them are coming from base, right? We know Kale's still down, right? Kale's still down. But that probably means the other two are around here. Dragon is almost up, and it's a good dragon to get. If instead of making the call by putting myself in the turret line and tanking, I instead whimsy somebody, you know? And then we all start heading down here to Dragon. We take Scuttle, check blue buff on the way, get blue buff. Dragon's ours, you know? It's a denied dragon from a Mordekaiser. It's an infernal drake in our favor. Instead, Malphite dies. We burn a bunch of cooldowns. Or excuse me, I think it's a mountain drake, actually. That must be wrong. They get mountain drake. You know? All because of the shot call I made for the team by putting myself in danger, by making myself take the turret. We get another mountain drake. We can take the next baron a lot quicker. We can knock down these last four turrets a lot faster. Take the inhibs a lot faster. Frees us up to rotate and reset these lanes. Fizz, even with how low he was, could reset this wave. Somebody else could be resetting this wave. Instead, we have to deal with them getting the dragon. Still powering forward. One, because it's a little late. But two, because I'm looking for that dragon. Yeah, here we go. Mordekaiser's just bringing his pet dragon with him in the bot lane. That makes a split devastating. They can all be up here, pressuring this turret. And Mordekaiser alone with the dragon can pressure the bottom turret. And we can't answer that. There's no way we can split our wave clear properly when they're still wearing Baron. Not all of them, but Blitz has a Baron up here. Mordekaiser has a dragon down here. We can't answer this effectively. Burning the cooldowns, it's just they get to do this. They get to do this. We had to answer down here. Three of our members down here. Two of theirs and a dragon. That frees up three of them to dive us here. Not much we can do about that. Try and help Ezreal out. Can't do much. Already blew my ultimate. Going to regen. Trying to defend as best I can here. Trying to constantly auto to pressure the minions away. Clear the minions out as quickly as possible. Fizz almost gets a kill here. It's actually possible during all that that I could have been backing up Fizz a little bit more aggressively, right? If only he'd hit Blitzcrank with that. So Fizz is right here. Staying back myself. Eh, probably not. Probably fine. And remember, you see the particle effect, right? He's got a GA. Not only is he GA'd, but Kale just ulted him, so he's not dying. Even if he does, he's coming right back. So we're toast. Okay. Fizz died, and we got a GA. Not much help. You know? Didn't quite get the Blitz. Mouth finishes him off. Put the Mordekaiser 2 on the way out. Ezreal finishes it. Rengar off. We push the minions out as best we can. But we lost two inhibs, you know? At this point in the game, with two inhibs down, even though we just got almost an ace, it's just so much managing the super minions. There's not much that can be done. I could be out warding, but there are no objectives right now. What am I warding for, right? To say I warded? Not really moving anywhere on the map. Where we want to move is up mid. That's where all the pings are. So I go forward, throw down a ward here. I think, okay, the only way they're going to get us is from the flanks. So I'm just going to ward these flanks up if we want to take mid. Flank coming from Ahri. This is really bad map awareness right here. It's okay. I'm going to go ward this brush here. Right here. Fine. But I need to get my ass back there immediately. Because of this. Right? I'm hanging around Ezreal. But we need to go. This is the moment, right? Clear this out. This is the moment. He's propped Righteous Glory. She's possibly by herself right here. Fizz is coming on a flank to support us. We gotta go. I gotta go. I whimsied myself. Probably should have whimsied Malphite there. Nevertheless, we all gotta go. It's only upon Ezreal deciding to take that path. So I miss a whole chunk. Could have been here. Could have been leading Ezreal. How far ahead I am of Ezreal? Remember, I should be double that. So I should be right behind Malphite right here. All of my abilities are castable on Malphite right now. That big of a gap? I should be right on Malphite. I should be able to turn her into a bunny right over this wall. Should have been able to send him in with a shield. Give him a little tremendo. Come back away. Fortune is cool. Give him a little speed buff. I'm hanging properly far back because I'm low. And like, this is a lost fight, I feel like. So, playing a little far back like this is fine. I'm trying to throw everything onto Ezreal. Especially because Zeke's is proccing right now. So we want to keep him empowered. Fizz is going to come in and try and make something work out of this, right? So I'm just throwing on Ezreal. Hopefully our damage works out. Ezreal's getting to free hit right now. Rengar's coming for me. Rengar came this way. Came for me. Alright, that's fine. Let's go back. Let's watch that. I think enabling Ezreal through a lot and just focusing on Ezreal was the right call because of how like free he was to output damage. Right here. Okay. He's on me. He's doing his Rengar thing. So he's coming for me. I flash away. Good. Try and slow him down with the glitter lance. That's Ezreal, so I don't want to leave him alone. Turn him into a bunny. Great. Throw the shield back on Ezreal. Wonderful. I think that was all fine play. But it's too late. Like, that's about it. That's about all she wrote. And as we'll see, that is in fact all she wrote. So, you know, when you wonder, like, how are we so far ahead, and we lost it, we end up losing the gold advantage despite that huge kill advantage. Despite having so many members that were, like, really unable to go off, and in ways that people aren't used to, so we can catch people off guard, and have really good team fight with it. How do we still lose that game? I think it's because of my map awareness. If nothing else, the final decision back here, when we were still so far behind, the decision to try and pressure this turret for nothing after they had both recalled, instead of going to take a dragon, deny the Drake, that could have kept these two inhibitors alive, you know? Despite all the stuff leading up to it, even just that minor change might have made the entire difference. So, you know, it's unfortunate. Maybe we could have, if we had better map awareness, we could have turned that into a victory. Unfortunately, we don't. So, we lose that one, even with a good scoreline. Even with a team that had overall good scorelines. Our gold wound up being less just because of all the objectives that we seeded over and over again. Like, we got one dragon that game. They got a whole bunch more. So, you know, it's not about just mechanical ability. It's not about playing every, like, combat situation properly. It's about map awareness and knowing where those opportunities are, knowing where you need to start moving, because you move slow in this game. Even when you get your boots, it still takes you a while to move around. I get Mobis on supports, and I've been playing all day today as supports, so I've had Mobis all the time. It still takes me a while to get places, you know? Boots 5 is not enough to just teleport somewhere. And even when you teleport, you have to channel. It takes a while. So it's really critical to have that time, and I think it really illustrated for you guys a couple of those times where I was this much out of position that I then had to walk back. So I could have been all the way over here instead. You know, I'm not sure if that's all the way on the screen for you guys. But that's stuff that could have been done better. And, you know, sometimes we don't make it happen. Sometimes we get punished. And this was one of those games where we got punished. So, despite any mistakes that were made with engages, I think this overall comes down to my map awareness being the weak link on the team this game. And this is something that we went into more detail in during, right after the game. We talked a lot about this itemization. Forgot to pay attention, Twitch chat, if you want to tell me what the itemization order was in-game, let me know. But I think this locket was probably a bad choice because we have so much gap creation in our team fight. We don't want to necessarily be out 1v1 getting picks like a Zed, you know? But we want to blow some people up, and we want to do that with, like, Malphite ult. We want people to be body slamming in to start the engage. We want Fizz to be playful trickstering in way deep into their backline, queuing in to get even further. So this is a good thought, always, to get that synergy. I think this is dependent on people being around you. And nobody was around me. You know, Ezreal was around me that game. You know, Gragas was around me that game sometimes. if I had got Redemption instead of Locket, when somebody goes forward really aggressively to engage, then I could possibly have triggered the Redemption where they were engaging too. So after the engagement goes off, and they maybe assassinate one person, maybe two people if we're really lucky to start off with an amazing engage, the remaining enemies are all going to attack you and all in you, right? And they're going to put out a lot of damage. And the trick is to not give those kills right back. In order to do that, we needed to have a little bit of sustained help there. And since I'm not going to be physically in range, just by virtue of them creating gaps to engage, I'm not going to be close enough to them physically to throw my shield on them, to use my ultimate on them. I need to be able to, from a distance, cast Redemption. And even with that aside, I definitely am not going to be able to make use out of Locket for that. And that's what decides this a lot. Is by if Fizz is going to be around, maybe not super healthy, but around, you know? If Malphite's going to be around, maybe not super healthy, but around. And they weren't, because I wasn't able to make use out of the items I built. This item, you know? This worked well with Ezreal, I feel. I was swapping it with Fizz a couple times when Ezreal would die and Fizz would be alive, and vice versa. Tried to always keep it on Ezreal if possible. I think this was fine. I really like this item. I always think this item's good. It works with Fizz and Ezreal. Not as much with Malphite because he's going for the burst, the full burst combo. Does give him a little extra info on that auto, but the auto's largely meaningless with this much burst. Gragas doesn't really use it. So, an okay buy this game. I like getting it when I have the shield champions. Maybe Lulu's not the best example of champion for that. Maybe I don't build it next game. Maybe instead I rush, Redemption into Zeke's, into Arden. Maybe get it late. Maybe don't build it all. Maybe get something else. Something tanky. Something with engage. Something that could speed me up, like Righteous Glory for myself, maybe, would be helpful. Get me in the thick of the fight. Allow me to stick to my allies when they engage. Slow everybody on the enemy team down. Probably would have been a good buy. Definitely don't think Locket was good though. But, you know, again, Locket would have been fine if I could have been there more often. Because I had the map awareness to see where the fights were breaking out, to see where people were positioning towards, seeing points of conflict emerge, seeing objectives being contested, like the red buff above Baron before they took Baron. You know? All that stuff adds up. But that's going to be the game. Hopefully you guys learned something from that. Map awareness, definitely key. Definitely makes a big difference. Not just your scoreline. So, you know, if this video was helpful for you guys, if you know somebody who could benefit from having a little bit better map awareness, feel free to send this their way. Feel free to, you know, let me know that this helped you out. If you did, leave a comment, leave a like, subscribe for more. And yeah, if you have any requests, if you want me to review one of your games, let you know some things that you could have done a little bit better, give you some in-depth analysis. I'm open to doing some additional analysis takes where we do, instead of just lessons from my plays throughout the day according to Twitch chat chosen, the games chosen, we can instead do your game, do a little coaching session instead. So if that's something you'd be interested in, you know, let me know, leave a comment, hop on Twitch chat when we're live, and maybe we'll cast your game, maybe we'll give you some advice. Till then, thanks for watching, stay tuned, we've always got more. See you guys next episode.